नमस्कार जगत ने तमाम खबर साथ हूँ मनीषा, स्वागत है आपनु क्रिमिनल मा। क्राइम की दुनिया में आज बात करीशू सामूहिक आपघात केस में एक व्यक्ति नो जीव के रीते बचियो, महसाणा में केवी रीते लुटारू गेंगे आंगड़िया पेढ़ी ने टार्गेट करी, गीर पंथक में परिणीता ने केवी रीते मड़ी दहेज न लावानी सजा, सूरत में एक गर्भवती महिला ने शा माटे आपघात करवो पड़ो, आ तमाम समाचारों विस्तार थी जोईशू क्रिमिनल मा। पुलिस ना चुस्त बंदोबस्त वच्चे पण एक शहर असलामत छे, आ शहर जाने कायदा नु कोई अस्तित्व ज ना होय तेम लागी रह्यु छे, त्यारे फरी बनेली एक गुनाहित घटनाए पुलिस नी ऊंघ हराम करी दीधी, जोईए कया शहर नी सलामती पर उठी रह्या छे अनेक सवाल। वेरनी वसूलात, ट्रिपल मर्डर केस ना त्रण आरोपी सकंजामा, जूनागढ़ चकचार ट्रिपल मर्डर केस घटनाए समग्र सोरठ पंथक मा अरेराटी फैलावी दीधी हती, जे शहर ने पवित्र धामोनु गढ़ गणवामां आवे छे ते शहर मा खेलायल मौत ना तांडवे समग्र जूनागढ़ पोलीस नी रात नी ऊंघ अने दिवस नो चैन छीनवी लीधो हतो, एवा जूनागढ़ पोलीसे वेर नी वसूलात करनार बे आरोपी ने जेल नी चार दीवाल पाछळ धकेली दीधा छे। 18 सप्टेम्बर 2016 जूनागढ़ नु जफर मैदान।
Mr. President, our priority goal of economic development requires internal peace and stability. My country has been the principal victim of terrorism, including that supported, sponsored and financed from abroad. We will not allow externally sponsored terrorism and threats of destabilization to cause turbulence in Pakistan. Tens of thousands of our citizens and thousands of our security personnel have been killed or injured in terrorist attacks. This has only reinforced our resolve to eliminate the scourge of terrorism. Our comprehensive strategy of law enforcement and targeted military operations has produced remarkable results and enabled Pakistan to turn the tide against terrorists. Pakistan's Zarbeyaz operation is the largest, most robust and most successful anti-terrorism campaign anywhere in the world, deploying 200,000 of our security forces. Our comprehensive national action plan has the complete endorsement of our people and our parliament as well as our security forces, all of whom have made heroic sacrifices to defeat terrorism. Mr. President, terrorism, however, is now a global phenomenon which must be addressed comprehensively and in all its forms, including state terrorism. The international community must coordinate its efforts to accomplish this. These efforts should be taken collectively and not unilaterally by the passage of any laws with extraterritorial application targeted against certain countries. We will not win the fight against terrorism and violent extremism so long as we do not address their root causes. These lie in poverty and ignorance, political and social injustice and oppression, foreign intervention and occupation and denial of the legitimate rights of the people and nations, especially the right to self-determination. Until these underlying causes are addressed, it will be difficult to counter the twisted narrative of violent extremists and terrorists. Mr. President, after 15 years of the current war in Afghanistan, the international community agrees that the only road to a lasting peace in that country is through a dialogue between the government in Kabul and the Afghan Taliban. Pakistan has long proposed this as the most viable course to end decades of conflict and suffering in Afghanistan. Based on this belief in a negotiated peace, and in response to request from President Ashraf Ghani, we have been facilitating the process of reconciliation in Afghanistan. There have been setbacks. That, however, is not a sufficient reason to abandon the path of peace and rely on the military option, which has failed for the past decade and a half to stabilize Afghanistan. Progress will be assured only when the Afghan parties themselves conclude that there is no military solution to the Afghan war and work assiduously through a meaningful dialogue process for achieving reconciliation and peace at home. Mr. President, over 3.5 decades of conflict and chaos in Afghanistan has had grave security and economic consequences for Pakistan. Almost 3 million Afghan refugees, to whom we opened our homes and hearts, remain in Pakistan. We hope to see them return to Afghanistan voluntarily and with dignity. Until they do, the international community must shoulder its responsibilities to sustain them. Mr. President, confrontation should not be our destiny in South Asia. Pakistan wants peace with India. We have gone the extra mile to achieve this, repeatedly offering a dialogue to address all outstanding issues. But India has posed unacceptable preconditions to engage in a dialogue. Let us be clear. Talks are no favor to Pakistan. Talks are in the interest of both countries. They are essential to resolve our differences, especially in Jammu and Kashmir dispute, and to avert the danger of any escalation. Mr. President, peace and normalization between Pakistan and India cannot be achieved without a resolution of the Kashmir dispute. This is an objective evaluation, not a partisan position. Our predictions have now been confirmed by events. A new generation of Kashmiris has risen spontaneously against India's illegal occupation, demanding freedom from occupation. Burhan Wani, the young leader murdered by Indian forces, has emerged as a symbol of the latest Kashmiri Intifada, a popular and peaceful freedom movement led by Kashmiris, young and old, men and women, armed only with an undying faith in the legitimacy of their cause and a hunger for freedom in their hearts. Mr. President, this indigenous uprising of the Kashmiris have been met as usual with brutal repression by India's occupation force of over 500,000 soldiers. Over 100 Kashmiris have been killed, hundreds including children and infants blinded by shotgun pellets, and over 6,000 unarmed civilians injured over the past 2 months. These Indian brutalities are well documented. I would like to inform the General Assembly that Pakistan will share with the Secretary General a dossier containing detailed information and evidence of the gross and systematic violations of human rights committed by Indian forces in occupied Jammu and Kashmir. These brutalities will not suppress the spirit of the Kashmiris. It will only intensify their anger and fortify their determination to see India end its occupation of Kashmir. From Srinagar to Sopur, the men, women and children come out each day defying curfew to demand freedom. Mr. President, Pakistan fully supports the demand of the Kashmiri people for self-determination as promised to them by several Security Council resolutions. Their struggle is a legitimate one for liberation from alien occupation. international law and declarations of the United Nations on self-determination give the Kashmiri people the right to struggle for their freedom. Every year, the General Assembly unanimously adopts the resolution which reaffirms the right of all peoples to self-determination and calls on the states concerned to immediately end their occupation and all acts of repression. Mr. President, on behalf of the Kashmiri people, on behalf of the mothers, wives, sisters and fathers of the innocent Kashmiri children, women and men who have been killed, blinded and injured, on behalf of the Pakistani nation, I demand an independent inquiry into the extrajudicial killings and a UN fact-finding mission to investigate brutalities perpetrated by the Indian occupying forces so that those guilty of these atrocities are punished. We demand the immediate release of all Kashmiri political prisoners, an end to the curfew, freedom for the Kashmiris to demonstrate peacefully, urgent medical help for the injured, and abrogation of India's draconian laws. Mr. President, the Security Council has called for the exercise of the right to self-determination by the people of Jammu and Kashmir through a free and fair plebiscite held under United Nations auspices. The people of Kashmir have waited 70 years for implementation of this promise. The Security Council must honor its commitments by implementing its own decisions. This General Assembly must demand that India deliver on the commitments its leaders solemnly made on many occasions. To this end, steps should be taken by the United Nations to demilitarize Jammu and Kashmir and undertake consultations with India, Pakistan and the true representatives of the Kashmiri people to implement the resolutions of the Security Council. In this context, we welcome the offer of the good offices by Secretary General Ban Ki-moon. We will also open consultations with members of the Security Council to explore the modalities for implementation of the Security Council resolutions on Kashmir. Mr. President, the international community ignores the danger of rising tensions in South Asia at its own peril. For its part, Pakistan is committed to the establishment of strategic stability in the region. It neither wants nor is it engaged in an arms race with India. But we cannot ignore our neighbor's unprecedented arms buildup and will take whatever measures are necessary to maintain credible deterrence. We have consistently urged the conclusion of bilateral arms control and disarmament measures between Pakistan and India to prevent conflict and avoid wasteful military expenditure. We are open to discussing all measures of restraint and responsibility with India in any forum or format and without any conditions. We are ready for talks to agree on a bilateral nuclear test ban treaty. Today, from this rostrum, I would also like to reiterate our offer to India to enter into a serious and sustained dialogue for the peaceful resolution of all outstanding disputes, especially Jammu and Kashmir. Mr. President, as a responsible nuclear weapon state, Pakistan will continue to cooperate with all international efforts that seek to promote fair and equitable solutions to disarmament and non-proliferation challenges. We have introduced state-of-the-art measures to strengthen the safety and security of our nuclear materials and facilities. We have adopted a comprehensive export control regime that is fully consistent with international standards. Judged on the basis of objective criteria and without discrimination, Pakistan is fully eligible for membership of the Nuclear Suppliers Group. Mr. President, in our turbulent and interdependent world, the United Nations remains an indispensable organization to restore order and ensure global peace, stability and prosperity. Its principles remain the crucial pillars of international legality, the guide for the conduct of member states and the guarantor of the legitimate rights of all nations and peoples. The United Nations must regain its credibility as a central instrument for the promotion of peace, prosperity and liberty. To that end, it should become more representative, transparent and accountable. A comprehensive and democratic reform of the Security Council, which Pakistan supports, should enhance its relevance and representation. Creating new centers of privilege will do the opposite. Mr. President, Pakistan's unwavering commitment to the UN is well established. We have played a pioneering and consistent role in UN peacekeeping. And despite our own security requirements, we will remain one of the world's largest troop contributing countries and maintain our record of success in multiple UN peacekeeping operations. Mr. President, Pakistan has a vital stake in ending conflicts, fostering peace, fighting terrorism, strengthening democracy, promoting human rights, generating global growth and overcoming the challenges of environmental degradation. We can achieve these goals and create a new and peaceful world order only through the United Nations and by strict adherence to the principles of its charter. I thank you, Mr. President.
On behalf of the General Assembly, I wish to thank the Prime Minister of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan for the statement just delivered, and I request protocol to escort His Excellency.
ફરી એકવાર તેમણે કાશ્મીર રાગ આલાપ્યો. ઘણી બધી બાબતો નવાઝ શરીફે યુએન સમક્ષ રજૂ કરી. સાથોસાથ તેમણે જણાવ્યું, સાથોસાથ સૌથી ચોંકાવનારી વાત નવાઝ શરીફે યુએન સમક્ષ કરી, બુરહાન વાની, આતંકી બુરહાન વાનીને તેમણે કાશ્મીરનો અવાજ ગણાવ્યો, યુવા નેતા ગણાવ્યો અને જણાવ્યું કે ભારતીય સૈન્ય દ્વારા તે કાશ્મીરીઓ પર અત્યાચાર કરવામાં આવે છે, ક્રૂરતા કરવામાં આવે છે. પાકિસ્તાન સતત આતંકવાદનો ભોગ બની રહ્યું છે, અમે બહારની તાકાતોને અમારા પર હાવી નહીં થવા દઈએ. નવાઝ શરીફનું યુએનમાં સંબોધન એટલા માટે ખૂબ મહત્વપૂર્ણ માનવામાં આવી રહ્યું છે. ઉરીમાં આતંકી હુમલા બાદ ભારતીય સેના અને ભારતીય જે રણનીતિ ઘડવામાં આવી રહી છે પાકિસ્તાન વિરુદ્ધ, તેને લઈને હવે પાકિસ્તાન પણ જાણે સતર્ક થયું છે. પાકિસ્તાનમાં જાણે ભય હોય તેવું નવાઝ શરીફના સંબોધનથી લાગી રહ્યું છે. ફરી એકવાર તેમણે યુએન સમક્ષ, સંયુક્ત રાષ્ટ્ર સમક્ષ કાશ્મીરનો મુદ્દો ઉઠાવ્યો. સાથોસાથ તેમણે જણાવ્યું કે તે યુએનને, સંયુક્ત રાષ્ટ્રને એક ડોઝિયર સોંપશે, જેમાં કાશ્મીરમાં થઈ રહેલી ભારતીય સૈન્ય દ્વારા જે ક્રૂરતા આચરવામાં આવી રહી છે તેનો રિપોર્ટ તે સોંપશે અને તેના સામે કાર્યવાહી કરવા પણ નવાઝ શરીફે માંગ કરી છે. તો સાથોસાથ તેમણે જણાવ્યું કે ભારતે વાતચીત માટે અવનવી શરતો મૂકી રહ્યું છે, વાતચીત બંને દેશોના હિતમાં છે. કાશ્મીરના મુદ્દાઓને હલ કરવા પાકિસ્તાન માંગે છે. બુરહાન વાની કાશ્મીરનો અવાજ હોવાનું નવાઝ શરીફે જણાવ્યું. કાશ્મીરની નવી પીઢી આઝાદી ઈચ્છી રહી છે, નવી પેઢી છે કાશ્મીરની, એ આઝાદી ઈચ્છી રહ્યો હોવાની વાત નવાઝ શરીફે પોતાના સંબોધનમાં જણાવી અને સૌથી ચોંકાવનારી બાબત દર્શક મિત્રો કે એક તરફ નાપાક હરકતો કરી રહ્યું છે, બીજી તરફ આતંકીને તે કાશ્મીરનો અવાજ ગણાવી રહ્યું છે, આતંકીને કાશ્મીરનો નેતા ગણાવી રહ્યા છે. તો કાશ્મીરને હાસિલ જમ્મુ કાશ્મીરને હાસિલ કરવા માટે નવાઝ શરીફે ફરી એકવાર કાશ્મીર રાગ યુએન સમક્ષ આલાપ્યો છે અને સાથોસાથ જણાવ્યું છે કે કાશ્મીરમાં જે હાલની સ્થિતિ છે તેના માટે ભારતીય નિયમો અને ભારતીય સૈન્યની જે કાર્યવાહી છે તે જવાબદાર છે. તેમણે સંયુક્ત રાષ્ટ્રને જણાવ્યું કે આ અંગે તપાસ થવી જોઈએ. સંયુક્ત રાષ્ટ્રમાં પાકિસ્તાનના પીએમ નવાઝ શરીફ સંબોધન કરી રહ્યા હતા. ભારત પાકિસ્તાન સાથે ભારત સાથે પાકિસ્તાન શાંતિ ઈચ્છી રહ્યું છે તેવું નવાઝ શરીફે રાગ આલાપ્યો છે. જોકે દર્શક મિત્રો, હંમેશા એવું થતું આવ્યું છે કે નવાઝ શરીફ બોલે છે કંઈક અલગ અને તેમના તરફથી થતા કૃત્યો કંઈક અલગ જ ભાષા બોલે છે.